Hello, VC. This is Bev here, and this is kind of an impromptu video. I just thought I would throw this out there now while I was kind of sort of in the mood. Amazon just popped a CD through the door. Now, after my latest videos from the charity shop saying that my spending was pretty much done for the month, I went and ordered a couple of CDs off Amazon because they were kind of cheap. This one that came in tonight is $7.99, I think it was. And for me, that's a great price for the CD, considering if you get an original press, you're looking at £15 upwards, I think. It's quite tricky to get a hold of. But it took me by surprise when I discovered Amazon had it. I think it's a reissue. I'm pretty sure it's a reissue. I don't think it can be an original. But it's Gotthard, self-titled. This is their debut album, which was originally released in 1992. And I think the original album, the cover comes in different colours. This is a green one, obviously. You can get it in red and blue, I think, as well. For some reason, kind of like Big Country with the Crossing album. Was like that as well back in the day. But this is BMG Ariola. I think Ariola was the original record label from the time, but I can't be 100%, but I think so. But I'm pretty sure BMG have re-released these. It doesn't say what year this actually was. It does have 1992 inside somewhere. And it was made in Germany, and of course, in true Amazon fashion, of course, it's it's a crack up here, so that falls off, and there's actually a crack right up there as well, which means that the tray is easy to come out. So dual case required there. I'm actually getting sick to the back teeth of Amazon. Just for the damage that the sleeves and the cases, it's just unnecessary. They obviously chuck their stock about when it comes in, you know. They just, oh, chuck those CDs over there, chuck these records over there. That must be how they do it. But however, the CD's in lovely condition, you know. I thought, is this a second hand one that's been returned? It was in a shrink wrap. It was very flimsy shrink wrap. And I've had that once before with a CD where I wondered, because when I took the shrink off, the jewel case had kind of scuffs and marks on it, which made me wonder. However, well, no worry too much about that. The main thing is I've got the CD. I've been wanting this for a long time. Now, to get the record, obviously, you have to be a lottery winner to get the record, because it's a 90s record, obviously, and I don't think it's been reissued. So. And I was just having a quick look at the linear notes. If I can get this thing out here, front, that side looks like that, and it's just one of these fold-out things. Just folds out like so, and there is the band, young Gotthard at the time. Yep, that guy there, that was Steve Lee, the guy that died tragically in 2011, I think it was. But all these four guys, they're, well, apart from Steve Lee, who's passed on, obviously, but the other three guys that you see there, they're still in the band today as well. But what I noticed was interesting about this, I've heard a couple of the songs from this album, but I've not heard all of it. But it says, I was reading the notes, and it says, special guest Vivian Campbell, lead guitars on Fire Dance and Get Down. Fire Dance is a great song, actually. I thought, God, Vivian Campbell gets around, does he not? So he's been a guest on one of the tracks on here. This would be 1992. So, which is around the time he just joined Def Leppard, as it happens as well. So I don't know if, you know, that particular recording was done before he went to Def Leppard or what. I have no idea. But anyway, I just thought that was kind of interesting, and I would throw that out there. They've since added another guitarist, because it was guitars, vocals, drums and bass, I think it is here. But they are now a two-guitar band. They have a second guitar player as well. And sometimes they have a keyboardist who's like a guest musician that kind of tours with them sometimes. So, I just wanted to mention that to say I'm thrilled to get this. So I'm looking forward to giving that a listen to and getting a new case. Wonder if I'll buy a set of jewel cases from Amazon. Just the empty cases, if they'll come in one piece, or if we'll need to buy some more to replace the ones I've just bought. The other thing I wanted to just do while I was on here is to give a quick shout out to a nice guy called Fraser Dawson. He was on the live chat on Vinylizer's video that his live stream that he put out yesterday afternoon. He was on that, and I joined in. I just happened to see he was online at the time, so there was about three or four or five of us maybe chatting away, and Fraser mentioned GloryHammer, this band here, and because he was chatting away to John, and he said that he was going on holiday this year to Scotland and England. I think he said he had relatives over this side of the pond. And then GloryHammer came up somehow in the conversation, and he said that GloryHammer are actually from Scotland, and I think they're actually Swedish. I was, you know, convinced they were Swedish. I says, but the album, they do an album and it's about Scotland, because this is called Tales from the Kingdom of Fife. And these guys are power metal, by the way, and they're really good. This is a good album. It's quite a fun album, actually. So I said, no, I'm convinced they're Swedish. And he's, no, they're actually from Scotland. And I'm like, okay, right, you know, and I'm thinking to myself, I'm convinced. So I says, no, it's fine. I says, maybe I'm wrong. But so later on that day, I went and did a bit of checking. I'm thinking, how did I find out they were Swedish? And it turns out they weren't Swedish. They're not Swedish. But I initially thought they were Swiss, from Switzerland, because I featured them in my competition entry that DJ High Noon recently held for his 1 year in the VC and 400 subs, or was it 300 subs, something like that. And I featured them in the competition, and I'm busy saying in that video, these guys, because my connection was Scotland, I says, these guys are actually Swiss, from Switzerland, I says, but the album's about Scotland, and that was how it connected with my theme. So I thought, how the devil did I think they were Swiss? And yesterday I must have just been thinking Sweden instead of Switzerland. So I'm busy, I googled it all, and I'm looking down at all the search things that it brought up. And I must have just glanced at initially the beginning part of when you get Wikipedia come up with something. It said that the GloryHammer are an Anglo-Swiss band, and I think when I saw Anglo-Swiss, that must have been what I took in at the time. But I read further on, and then I checked a couple of other results that came up. I read a couple of reviews, I even went on Discogs, and right enough, they are British. One of them had them down as the United Kingdom, one of the places I looked at. And Discogs had the UK as well, but it said location or country of origin, Scotland. So one of them, I can't remember which, but one of them said Scotland and one said Britain or the UK. So I just wanted to say, Fraser, you're dead right. You're absolutely spot on. GloryHammer appear to be from Scotland, which makes perfect sense, because that'll explain their kind of knowledge about the whole areas of Scotland, because they've got lots of place names in their songs from Scotland. And then, so I got the album out and I'm looking at the credits down here. And the names of the band members, they've got Thomas Winkler on vocals. You've got Paul Templing on guitars. James Cartwright bass. Christopher Bowes keyboards and Ben Turk on drums. Now they, for a start, they don't sound like Swedish or Swiss names either. They kind of sound a bit more kind of, I don't know, English, Scottish, English speaking type country type names, if that makes any sense. I'm thinking, well, they certainly don't sound like they're Swiss names or Swedish names or German names or anything like that. So I think initially I never took the time to study the details about GloryHammer correctly, and therefore I got it into my head that they were from Switzerland. And then yesterday, obviously, I think it was the S, and I thought Sweden, because a lot of the power metal bands then were from Sweden, obviously, but. But no, it would appear that they are very much from Scotland, so I'm kind of chuffed about that as well. It's nice that Scotland have produced another kind of really interesting band. So that was that. So Fraser, I just wanted to say, spot on, I got myself completely mixed up there, and now I'm sitting thinking to myself, so I've just made myself look like a right clown in DJ Hynoon's video, if anybody else goes to watch that now. DJ Hynoon's entry, for the entry I did, I make myself look like an idiot here as well. But so that is that. So I just wanted to just put that bit out there, to say that I completely got that one wrong, and I'm actually quite surprised, pleasantly surprised, that these guys are from Scotland. And thanks to Fraser for setting me straight, because I don't know how long I would have gone on thinking they were from Europe, mainland Europe, before the penny dropped. It might have dropped eventually for me, but I could have been seeing so many daft things and people looking at me as if I had horns in my head. But anyway, I recommend this band if you're into the power metal scene. It's, as I say, it's quite a fun album. They've got a new album coming out, I think it's early August. I think I'm going to order it, or pre-order it. So yeah. So that is GloryHammer and my Gotthard CD. Fantastic. Love this band. I urge you to check them out as well. Excuse me, and I'll stop blabbering for the moment and catch you all in another video. Bye bye.